three, four.
I play bass with the trio. I've been playing music most of my life. When I was a teenager, my older sister saw my interest and bought me an inexpensive guitar, and I mean really inexpensive. This thing was just awful. The strings were like way high off the fingerboard, and it was just plywood, and the frets were actually hammered into the neck. There was no fingerboard. But nobody told me it was a bad guitar, so I just kept practicing on it and got a little better, and then finally, my parents realized I could probably do a little better, and when I was a year older, they helped me get a nice guitar, and that just got me going. Later on, I got really interested in classical music, and so I went to Michigan State and studied music composition. I was an awful student, really awful. I actually had a professor tell me I should drop out of the program and make room for talented students, but that didn't stop me. So I did leave school for a while, took a semester off, which I tell people lasted several years. And I recorded some rock and roll in Baltimore, Maryland in 74. And then did some record production. I produced a few albums. Moved to Chicago and was VP of a television station. So I've been in and around the music and the arts for a long time. And then I just kind of stopped doing that for a while. I was married, we raised kids, I went back to school and earned a PhD. About 20 or so years ago, I moved to the Saginaw area to be a professor at Saginaw Valley. And I met Jim Pagel. There was a local church that would do a big Christmas service, and people would come 3 hours early to get seats. And so the worship pastor said, I would love to be able to find two guitarists who could just improvise on guitar for a couple of hours. And the worship director said, well, the only two guitarists I know who could probably do that would be Jim Pagel and George Puya, but they don't really know each other. So the first time I met Jim, we walked onto a platform. I shook hands, we sat down next to each other, and we improvised music for the next 2 hours or so. And we would just connect on and off for a number of years. The way I became involved in the trio, I had actually never played bass. And Jim called one afternoon and said, do you play bass? And I said, I probably could. I mean, I play a lot of stringed instruments, but I might even have a bass in my closet, but I don't really play it. And he goes, oh, George, I'm really stuck. I have a regular bass player and some backups, and none of them are available. Do you think you could sit in for a couple of weeks? So that was 4 years ago. So I really fell in love with doing this kind of music. I love gypsy jazz. I love this style of music that was so popular in the United States and Europe in the 30s and has been so popular continuously in Europe. So I took some lessons online, bought myself a little bit better bass, and I'm still learning, but I love doing this.
Jason Cox. I play the rhythm guitar and every now and then lead in the trio. And I got started way back, I guess, we'll really call it 11. I tried when I was six. I tried playing guitar, but I couldn't quite grasp it. Also, the teacher I had at the time was more or less strict to the book and less about kind of like what I should practice and just kind of what was the best learning method for me. Also, I was just way too young. 11 is when I really got into it. I had an instructor named Mike Beckman. He taught me for probably, I want to say, 5 years. I started a rock band with my instructor, Mike, and my longtime friend, Nolan. He played drums in the band. We were just a rock group. We played a lot of covers. A lot of originals is what we like to write. We had a nice little following. I played my first bar gig when I was roughly 13, which is always fun trying to get into bars when they think that the law is that you're not allowed to be in the bar at a certain age when it's actually up to the bar's discretion, but that's okay. Then after a while of still doing all that, all the shows with my band at the time called Operation 13, with Mike, my instructor, and my drummer, Mike, my instructor, recommended if I wanted to take my guitar playing to another level, if I ever wanted to get better at it, because he thought that I kind of reached a ceiling with him, that I should go see Jim Pagel, a great musician, as obvious, but as we all know here. So I had a couple lessons with Jim, and towards the ending of the lessons, he would kind of play this this music that he was into, and he was playing in a band at the time, and it was gypsy jazz, and I had never heard the music. I had never even heard of the music. So, and he's playing all these add nines and all these diminished chords. It was just a beautiful change up to me in the music world, as opposed to just playing your standard blues licks and your pentatonics and actually thinking about writing out solos. And I don't know, he challenged me to be better at music through the form of jazz, and it's not even all just through the form of jazz, but just through, I don't know, just really sitting down and taking the time with it. And then I kind of fell in love with the music, and I filled in a couple of times with Jim. And I told him, I was like, hey, if you ever needed someone to finally, or if you ever had something happen to the other rhythm guitar player, I would love to play it. And he said, okay. And after a few years down the road, he was like, are you sure you'd like to do this? Because I would get you in the band and I would like to have that happen. And I said, absolutely. And so now, from there on out, I have been probably with the group almost 5 years now, at least four. And yeah, it's been really fun.
Hello, my name is Jim Pagel. I'm the leader of the Jim Pagel Jazz Trio. We play all over mid-Michigan, probably 6-8 times a month right now currently. We used to play as many times as 12 to 14 before COVID, but we love to play jazz, and I've been playing jazz for about 9 years, roughly speaking, maybe a little over. I've been playing guitar for 39 years. I started in 1983. October, actually, so next month is my guitar birthday. 39 years, 9 years of jazz, teaching guitar for almost 32. January will be 32 years since I started teaching guitar. My journey has been very diverse. Started with rock and roll and blues, and did that for probably 10 years, 12 years. Mid-20s, I started having a family and realized I didn't want to be out late in bars playing till 2 in the morning anymore, so I decided to teach myself how to play acoustic and finger-picking music so I could play restaurants, play like dinner guitar stuff. Did that from 25 to about 30. So at 30, having more kids and getting married and getting a real day job, I still taught a little bit and still played a little bit, but I kind of pulled away from music for a while. And in about 40 or so, I lost my day job and I realized that I really wanted to get back into guitar playing again, and teaching again. So I started building up a repertoire of students, and shortly thereafter, I decided to take on this new style called Gypsy Jazz. Gypsy Jazz came from France in the 30s and 40s from a guitar player named Django Reinhardt. I got really excited about it and decided to reach out to some of the best Gypsy Jazz guitarists in the world through Facebook. And they all accepted my friendship, which I was pretty shocked by that at first. Then I realized there's people just like we are, and it's kind of an underground style, so they're kind of interested in teaching and making some money doing that. So I reached out to a couple different world-class Gypsy Jazz guitar players and took a few lessons just to kind of get some direction in the style. Did that for a bit, and I just had a lot of enthusiasm and drive to learn and study on my own, practicing 3-4 hours a day, and got the style down rather quickly. Within 3 months, I had the trio. And 3 months later, we opened up for Robin Nolan, who's one of the premier Gypsy Jazz guitar players from Europe. We opened up for him at the Bay City State Theater. That was February of 14, and here we are coming up on 2023. And we still play quite a bit and still practice quite a bit and still want to get better at this style. But it's been a joy, and it's a joy to play with George and Jason. And we have guest musicians that drop in with us, some students that have been working really hard. And it's just been a joy, and hopefully we'll keep this ball rolling. Thank you for listening.
Hi, my name's Anthony Christie. I've been playing Gypsy Jazz for the past 2 years. Always was in the music, credited with my grandma. When we were young, she would play the piano and she'd play like Hold That Tiger and we'd all dance around, or she actually would play ukulele. Taught me a few chords. Later in life, I was a gas station attendant, and when I'd open up, The owner don't never touch the man's station. He'd always listen to kind of the same thing my grandma, like the Glenn Miller, the big band swing. And I couldn't touch a station. And I was a metalhead at the time. So I kind of cringed, but I just kind of learned to love it. Got away from music for quite a few years. And one lucky day, I was in Bay City downtown, and I saw the trio, and was, you know, just like awed of that style of music that I was hearing from when I was a child, and met Jim on a break, and I said, you know, I really like Django Reinhardt and stuff like that, and he says, oh, I got a song for you. Then they got up, the very next song they played was a Django Reinhardt, and then I was tooken. So jumped into lessons, picked up the guitar after a few years, and blessed enough that Jim pushed me and would say, well, here, you're gonna sit in with us on this gig, or it went from one set to two sets, and poor guy still gotta put up with me. And so my story's but very simple, but having a joy just playing again.